So you have two confessions. One murderer and one liar. What's your next step?
When in doubt, go back to the evidence. Only I'm not finding anything conclusive here. Both the mother and daughter have motive. Either one of them could have worn the robe. Both were linked to the victim's blood. I just can't find anything that points to either of them conclusively.
German philosopher Arthur Schopenhauer said, "Every man takes the limits of his own field of vision for the limits of the world." It's possible you're letting your own perspective blind you to the evidence.
Are you seeing something that we're not?
Not from here. Go back to the scene of the crime. Put yourself in the killer's place. And remember, even the best of us can miss important evidence sometimes.
Huh. I wonder if Gris ever gets tired of being right. If I were standing where the assailant did and struck the victim, then when the weapon came back, the blood cast off would fly right, because I'm right-handed. From this position, spatter clearly swings to the left, hitting the wall, with no swings to the right. Our killer is left-handed. Now we just have to find evidence to determine whether the lefty is mother or daughter. Based on the slants of the letters and the direction of the smudge marks, we can safely say that Mrs. Van der Riet is left-handed. Place settings in the daughter's kitchen indicate one is right-handed, the other left. Crossword handwriting says the mother was the definite lefty. We have our killer.
She's on her way to interrogation now.
Your daughter also confessed to the murder of your husband, but the evidence agrees with your version.
Of course it does. She is innocent, trying to protect me.
We know, Mrs. Van der Riet. Your daughter is right-handed, but Mr. Van der Riet was killed by a left-handed person, like yourself.
I owe you thanks. I know I said some cruel things to you before, and I am sure my daughter has done the same. But I thank you for finding the truth in this, and not allowing to stand the injustice of my daughter being blamed for my act. She should be free. She has been inside the prison my husband built for her long enough. No, I won't. I told you. I explained it. Weren't you listening? I killed my father, and I'd do it again.
Maybe you would do it again if you had the chance. Only you didn't do it in the first place. Forensics tells us your father's killer was left-handed, like your mother. You're right-handed, meaning there's little chance you could have wielded that fireplace poker. Much as it may disappoint you, Adya, you're innocent. Your mother could no longer bear her controlling husband, so she grabbed the fireplace poker and, for once, took charge of her own life. And his. Then she went to your house and you helped her wash off before she hid the robe at the pool house.
All right, but before you go any further, stop and think. She didn't do this for herself. She did it to protect me. All those terrible years, she never once complained, never challenged that demon. My father was the monster here, my mother the victim. To be pitied, not tried for this necessary execution.
We did fine. Great, in fact. Nice having another sharp pair of eyes. Justice may be blind, but CSI's gotta see every detail. Check in with Gris for your evaluation.
All right, here's your evaluation. For evidence, there were a few items you didn't find or fully process. For hints, you didn't need any at all. And at the end of the day, you followed the evidence to a clear conclusion. I can't argue with that. Well, you passed, but just barely. I'd like to see improvement before giving a higher mark. And by the way, thank you for all the new specimens you found for my collection. I'm recommending you for an extra bonus. Great hunting.